This tutorial demonstrates a direct application of the test case class, Simple. The AUnit tutorials use a directory structure in which test cases are located in the scenarios directory, and test suites and the main program are located in the harness directory. Also, for every package under test P, there exists a child package, p.test, where the child package test contains the test case class. Hence, for the package math, we have the child package math.test. Here is the interface to be tested. As for the body, it has been stubbed out. It is normal practice in test-driven development to delay implementation of the body until the testing activity can prove that the interface is testable. After all, if an interface is not testable in a straightforward manner, then there is a problem with the design, which often requires a change to the interface. If a body has been developed for an interface that must be changed, then the time and money invested in the implementation is lost due to the need for rework or even a complete rewrite of the body. So, in addition to providing a software system with regression tests, with all the obvious advantages, the unit testing activity also validates the interfaces and hence the architecture. Okay, let's walk through the test code. Well, the first thing we do is declare a test case class of type simple and provide it with some test attributes which become part of the so-called test scaffolding. The inherited methods setup and teardown may be overridden as is done in this example. We use the keyword overriding to indicate a conscious decision to override inherited procedures as opposed to creating new procedures. The inherited methods run, test, and name are declared as abstract in the superclass and therefore must be implemented here. Setup and teardown bracket the invocation of run, test, so you can be assured that the framework will invoke setup to initialize any attributes of the test scaffolding, run your unit test, and then run teardown. When using the simple test case directly, as we're doing here, there's only one place available in which to locate your test code, and that is in the run test procedure. If you need to organize, isolate, run, and report tests as different scenarios of a test case, then you should not be using the simple test case directly. Remember, this test case is only used to create quick and dirty tests that will be thrown away. By examining the interface contract for the unit under test, and knowing the values of the elements in the test scaffolding, we determine that the expected value must be 6, that is 5 plus 3 minus 2 equals 6. Normally, an assert is dedicated to one function point at a time, but with a simple test case, anything's allowed. Therefore, we let the condition expression in assert invoke two function calls, namely add and subtract. If the assertion condition actual equals expected is false, then the framework will report the problem using the error message provided. Name must be implemented, and here we assign a name to the test case. In the math suite, which I've implemented as a function without a package in this case, here we declare a reference to the new test suite using the new keyword. Yeah, and then incorporate the test case into the test suite with the add test method. In the math harness, we instantiate a runner from the generic procedure test runner using the math suite function as an input parameter. We then declare a reporter to output test results as plain text. And we pass the reporter to the runner. Now we have a runnable program. If that's the case, let's execute the application. So, as expected, our test fails because we know that the body has been stopped out, that is, the body of the unit under test has been stopped out. So we've proven that the interface is testable, in which case we can proceed with the implementation of the body, which for this contrived example involves two lines. Remove the stub. Hit then compile. Build. Run. And now we see that our test was indeed successful, and the name of the test case has been identified. It's math test. Okay, then to summarize, a direct application of the simple test case class is useful for quickly producing tests with minimal effort. However, use of this class should be limited to informal, one-off, quick and dirty tests that will be thrown away.